Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. So we are looking at the first devblog for the next major update in War Thunder already. Well, I say already, but I guess... Well, yeah, but the last update came out like a month ago. I don't know. I know they always do an update at the end of the year, but I guess I just wasn't expecting to see devblogs so soon. Not that I'm complaining, that is. And we're starting things off with a new battleship, which is the Imperial Japanese Navy Fusō, which is a classic World War I era dreadnought battleship, but this is very clearly in one of her World War II refits. And obviously by the very iconic pagoda mast that she's using. But as far as knowing about this vessel, I believe we actually first saw this, like, I think it was in 2020 in a Japanese War Thunder promotional video, I believe on, like, Twitter. You could see it for a very brief amount of time, and then I think it appeared again, but it was never, like, shown off. And of course it was in various data mines and stuff. But I guess now we're finally getting it on the tech tree. I guess they were just waiting for the right time to bring it to the game. But let's go ahead and see. So Fusō is a lead ship, or the lead ship, of a pair of battleships built for the Imperial Japanese Navy before and completed during the First World War. Despite being a pre-World War I design, Fusō served throughout the interwar period and in World War II thanks to modernization, and is about to embark on a new campaign after its arrival in War Thunder, the next major update, which is titled Fire and Ice. See, it's like they kind of had the update ready to go out, because not only have we already gotten multiple dev blogs, we got a teaser video like a day after they had started showing the dev blogs, and we never really ever get the name of the update immediately, you know what I mean? So I think they were ready to ship this one, which is why we're getting so much information about it. In fact, they already did a dev server today, and this was uploaded on their website 2 days ago. So briefly, it is a Japanese World War I era battleship built to outmatch other contemporary battleships through the use of superior firepower. It's the Fusō. It's a battleship for Japan of the 5th rank. It features devastating large caliber guns, good armor protection, numerous anti-air weapons, but of course its drawback is its low mobility. So being a large vessel, I am going to continue with the trend of reading the actual history. Beginning with, after the launch of HMS Dreadnought in 1906 and HMS Invincible in 1907, two new warship classes emerged, the Dreadnought and the Battlecruiser. This caused considerable problems in Japan's naval expansion plans, as suddenly all ships currently in construction became obsolete. The decision was made to build newer ships, but due to an economic recession at the time, only one new battleship, later becoming the Fusō, and four battlecruisers, Kongo class, were ordered. Fusō was laid down in March 1912, launched 2 years later, and commissioned with the IJN in November 1915. Despite entering service during the First World War, Fusō didn't see any action in the Great War, as the Central Powers forces were no longer present in Asia at the time anymore. In the interwar period, Fusō conducted several training missions and underwent two full reconstructions between 1930 and 1941, substantially changing the ship's visual appearance and improving her combat capabilities. Yeah, if you look up her initial, like, World War I completion, you'll see just how different it actually looks compared to the version we see here in the game currently. By the start of World War II, Fusō was already considered to be a dated design, surpassed in combat capabilities by newer ships. Because of this, Fusō was largely relegated to auxiliary roles during the conflict, seeing little frontline action. Fusō's most notable engagement was also to become her last, taking part in the larger battle at Leyte Gulf. Fusō, along with her sister ship, Yamashiro, were both sunk in the Battle of Surigao Strait in October 1944. So, unfortunately, didn't really have that much of a fantastic service record to speak of. But it's nice to see her backing up the rest of Japan's Navy in War Thunder, as they had a handful of battleships to see, and we get obviously World War II battleships, and we get a World War II variant of an older battleship, which is very nice to see. And of course, this one's iconic throughout the community for just having that ridiculous bridge. But, well, now people can live out their memes in War Thunder. So in War Thunder, Fusō will be a new battleship coming to the ranks of the Imperial Japanese Navy with the release of the next major update, Fire and Ice. Coming to the game in its late World War II refit, Fusō packs some serious firepower thanks to its numerous large and medium caliber guns, while at the same time bristling with short-range anti-air weapons and also featuring strong armor protection, typical for this class of warship. Fusō's primary armament consists of an impressive 6 twin 14-inch or 356mm turrets, evenly distributed down the entire length of the ship. Possessing good firing angles and equally respectable ballistic properties, Fusō is capable of inflicting tremendous damage upon its enemies even at long-range engagements, but especially when firing off a full salvo at a single target. Naturally, Fusō also possesses a healthy secondary battery, consisting of 16 6-inch 152mm cannons, with 8 guns being mounted in casemates above the armored belt on either side of the ship's hull. Additionally, Fusō's dual-purpose armament consists of 4 dual 5-inch or 127mm, which can engage both aerial as well as surface targets. Lastly, Fusō's dedicated anti-air battery consists of an impressive 89 25mm cannons. Is that all? Here we are with that fucking Japanese World War II battleship anti-air. It's ridiculous, man. These are split down into 16 dual, 8 triple, as well as 33 single turrets. Anti-air battery is complemented with 10 heavy machine guns. It will take a truly audacious and skilled pilot to break through these anti-air defenses. Being a battleship, Fusō doesn't just come fitted with impressive firepower, but also strong armor protection to boot. Namely, Fusō's main belt reaches 305mm in thickness at its strongest points, a standard figure found on most other contemporary battleships of the time period. Equally well protected are Fusō's main turrets and conning tower with up to 279 and 305mm of steel armor, respectively. In addition to strong armor, another aspect which will boost Fusō's combat endurance is the size of its crew, namely arriving to the game in its late World War II refit. Fusō is crewed by a total of 1,900 sailors, thus having one of the largest complements in the game. And here we've got some nice side screen shit, so you can see the casemate weapons, the main turrets, you can see various of the anti-air weapons plastered across the deck on top of the fucking turrets, which is just amazing. Can you imagine standing? Like, these guys aren't even sitting down. These guys on these turrets up here, are on the turret, on these little guns, these singular guns, they're standing on top of this thing. You fall off, you break a leg. And when these main guns fire, what the fuck? Can you imagine that? Anyways, here's a nice side profile shot. So you can actually still see the remnants of being a pre-World War I dreadnought design in that it's, well, very bare bones looking. Very flat. It's got a single smoke in the middle. But throw on some extra World War II spice and you've got yourself an iconic battleship. It's even got, looks like it's got a catapult in the rear, but they didn't say anything about having a recon plane at its disposal. As a result of all that firepower and armor protection, Fusō subsequently also displays an impressive displacement of 35,900 tons, which when coupled with its 75,000 horsepower propulsion system can bring the floating fortress up to a top speed of 21 knots or 39 kilometers an hour. As a result, Fusō has a rather average mobility in comparison to other contemporary battleships. So this is I don't know what I was going to say. I was going to say this is returning. This is arriving in the next major update, Fire and Ice, to the Japanese Blue Water Fleet tech tree, and is a pretty exciting way to start. Again, I mean, I'm very excited to see the Fusō in the game now, and I'm curious to see where else we're going to be going with this update. Of course, I know a little bit more since I'm getting to this video 2 days late. We have a whole new subtree coming to the Swedish tech tree. And yeah, so that's about it for this. So thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next War Thunder upcoming content video. Goodbye.